We are living in the greatest time of Mexican movie history. I know your dad and your grandma and your mom are gonna say it was back then with Cantinflas and Pedro Infante, but no. In 2014, the best director went to Gravity director Cuarón, which is Mexican. 2015, Alejandro González Iñárritu for Birdman. And in 2016, him again, won for The Revenant, and he gave Leonardo DiCaprio his first Oscar. And last year, in the greatest franchise in the history of cinema, we had Diego Luna, another Mexican actor, star in a Star Wars movie. And now you have Eugenio Derbez making another movie in Hollywood. So this is the greatest time for Mexican movie history. How to Be a Latin Lover stars Eugenio Derbez, Salma Hayek, Raphael Alejandro, Rob Lowe, Kristen Bell, and many other cameos. How to Be a Latin Lover is a movie about a man who spent 25 years living with a sugar mama, and then she finds a younger lover and kicks him out. Now, he must return with his sister and try to find himself a new sugar mama while adjusting to real life. Eugenio Derbez was one of my favorite actors as a kid when I grew up in Mexico. He had his own show called Derbez en Cuando, which had some of the most ridiculous characters, some of the funniest characters on television. And then he continued his career by making The Familia Peluche. They have The Familia Peluche, all the seasons on Netflix. If you guys are interested, if you guys didn't know about that, they're on Netflix. Also Chavez and all those classic Mexican TV shows. Now this movie is set up about him trying to find his way back and finding another sugar mama, but there's layers to this movie. The movie touches on immigration, family dynamics, and a relationship with his nephew, played by Raphael Alejandro, which is so amazing for a young actor. If you saw Instructions Not Included by Eugenio Derbez a couple years ago, you saw his relationship with the young actress, which is an amazing chemistry, and this movie does the same thing. Salma Hayek also does an excellent job in this movie, and I love that she was speaking Spanish, because I feel like I never really see her speak Spanish, which is kind of weird, but she was speaking a lot of Spanish in this movie, feeling like a real Mexican. If you're Mexican, you understand how the way she was acting, that's how moms and tías, and that's how they all act, which was very believable. The writing was really good in this movie. Now, this movie is extremely funny. It has a lot of great elements, especially if you're Latino. I like what this movie is doing, because if you're a Mexican or a Latino in the United States, and your mom or your dad or your grandma don't speak English, this movie could be something to go to the movies, because you never really go to the movies because they're not going to understand what's going on besides the visual effects and stuff. So it will be a good time to have a good time with your family this weekend or next weekend or during the week. Go watch this movie as soon as you can. Overall, this movie is hilarious. Everyone in your family is going to have a great time at the movies. I'm going to give this movie a grade of an A. My final grade for this movie might be a little bit subjective because I come from a Mexican background, so I'm going to understand more of the dynamics that happen. So if you're not familiar with it, go check this movie out. If you have Mexican friends, go watch it with them. Maybe they'll explain what's going on in certain scenes. So please check this movie out. As always, thank you guys for watching. My name is Angel. Don't forget to subscribe and give this video a thumbs up. You already made it this far. And as always, hit me up.